Hello, my name is Jan, and I would like to tell you about the Gloria Victis combat and how to defeat higher level players using your skills and knowledge. Let's start with the combat basics. First, directional attacks and blocks. You have to manually aim and time your swings, selecting one of the four directions with your mouse movement. When blocking with weapon, you have to block from the proper side, while shields protects from the entire front. Also, you can break from block by kicking your opponent. Blocking with shields provides 180 degrees protection in your front. However, your sides and back are still vulnerable. When blocking with weapons, you have to select direction matching the incoming attack. However, with proper positioning, you can block attacks coming from different directions at the same time. Shields can also be used as a weapon to bash your opponents and stun them. This gives you some time to strike a powerful hit. Note that if the enemy blocks your shield bash, you will be stunned instead for a while, allowing the opponent to counterattack. Attack power matters as well. When the enemy blocks your weak attack, you will be staggered and unable to block for a while, giving them enough time to counterattack. Fast attack can be effective, especially for quick counters, but use them with care. If you land stronger attacks and they get blocked, you won't be immobilized and left defenseless, but still, you are unable to attack for a while. This prevents spamming the opponent. Shields might seem to be an easier way of blocking, but there's a catch. They have a limited resistance. The defender can take several hits, but in the end, his hand will be limp, leaving him to rely on the directional blocking for a while. Note that the axes will do the job much faster. Fines are another useful technique. Start aiming an attack in the given direction, then press the blocking key to cancel the attack and distract your enemy. You can hit your opponents with the full power attacks to interrupt their swings. Not only you will deal decent damage, but also prevent them from harming you. Moreover, strong attacks with two-handed weapons will allow you to perform another epic stuff. Cleave, nothing better than a multi-kill. Cleave is one of the starting abilities, as well as bleeding. This applies a damage over time effect to the enemy hit with the dagger. It's being stacked with the future consequent attacks, up to the maximum limit. You have to maintain enough stamina, or your blocks won't be fully effective, and the opponent will break through them with the stronger attacks. Also, your attacks will be weaker if your stamina goes low. Stamina regenerates over time, but the regeneration speed depends on your movement. It's fastest when you stand still, and the slowest when you are running. With these basic mechanics and your knowledge, you will be able to defeat opponents with a much higher level. Let's take a look at the common mistakes and how to avoid them. Using the mismatched weapons and armor will get you in trouble. In this case, the player is using a knife and heavy armor. It's not the best combination. Of course, the plate armor is naturally resistant to slashing and piercing attacks, but even to the enemy switched to light armor, it still doesn't help much. While the armor protects you, reducing the damage which you do to an enemy, control your armor's weight and the damage multiplier. It's especially important when using fast weapons with low base damage, such as knives. As you can see, changing to light armor significantly increases the player damage without changing the weapon itself. Always look for the best position to attack from. Strikes from behind do much higher damage. Even the low level characters have access to some useful abilities, such as cleave and bleeding. Use them to maximize your efficiency in combat and fully utilize your equipment. Another common mistake is using a weapon which isn't effective against the opponent's armor. For example, a short sword won't do much harm to a heavily armored enemy. Using two-handed weapons, such as long swords, might not be enough too, as you can see in this example. So, why does the player deal so low damage to the veteran? Because he's using a weapon which doesn't match the enemy's armor. Played one, in this example, which is superior to slashing and piercing damage. But even the plate armor has its weak spots, bludgeoning damage and armor penetration. As you can see, even a simple wooden hammer is much more effective than swords and knives. Even a new player could craft such weapon. Just look how easy it is. As you can see, the damage is low, even though the player uses a proper weapon. Charge your swings to become more efficient. It will also prevent you from being staggered if the enemy blocks your attack. Also, keep repairing your equipment frequently. If an item is badly damaged, an indicator on the left will inform you about it. A damaged weapon will do much lower damage. The same applies to the armor protection. Now, let's see how different armors resist various weapon types. Medium armors are vulnerable to the piercing damage, as a chainmail can be easily penetrated by a spear. However, medium armors give decent protection against blunt weapons, such as hammers. And the slashing weapons, they are the least effective against medium armors. But in the case of a lightly armored opponent, a sharp sword will be your best choice. Light armors don't restrict the target's movement so much, so piercing damage won't be as much effective too. And the blunt weapons. Light armors provide really good protection against them, considering their little weight. Thanks for watching. You can use those tips, learn to avoid mistakes, and earn fame in combat. See you in battle!